hit is the end of Jacqueline and Arjun's romance. Akshay is furious at Bodyguard for breach of security. Shahid exclusively tells 9XE that he was scared of getting married. Salman says that difficult times are his share of karma. Hey guys, I'm Caitlin, and we've got a brilliant episode lined up for you on 9XE.com, the show. I'm hot, you're not, I'm a superstar. I'm a superstar. 9XE. We're always on the lookout for budding relationships in Bollywood, and recently on our radar was the romance between Jacqueline Fernandez and Arjun Kapoor. Two first set tongues wagging when they were spotted being extra chatty during the IFA Awards in Malaysia in June of this year. They also returned together from Malaysia. A while ago, the two were spotted enjoying a cozy dinner. And when 9XE.com, the show, had asked Jacqueline what exactly her relationship status with Arjun is, she gave a standard Bollywood answer.
We've been friends, good friends, and I think we're also both very into our careers right now. And that's our focus point. So I would not cross that line with someone who's such a great friend.
But now we can exclusively tell you what exactly their relationship status is. It is over. That's right, Jacqueline and Arjun are no longer a couple. It's done between them. Finished, khatam, khalas. Par dono ke beech hua kya? Jacqueline and Arjun felt that the spark that they had was no longer there. They felt that they were no more attracted to each other, so they decided to put an end to the romance rather than live through the animosity they now had towards each other. So basically, what began in Malaysia did not last too long in India. Rest in peace, Jacqueline and Arjun's relationship. So we might be mourning the demise of Jacqueline and Arjun's romance, but will Akshay Kumar's bodyguard be mourning the loss of his job? Akshay's trusted bodyguard, Shree, failed to do his job, and that left his boss fuming. The story goes that at a screening of Akshay's latest film, Singh Is Bling, held in Mumbai on Thursday, things got out of hand. Fans thronged the venue and a few were a little bit too happy to see their favourite star in person. When Akshay entered the venue, fans surrounded him. One fan got so close that he playfully slapped Akshay's back. The actor lost his cool and yelled at his bodyguard. Shree was taken aback but escorted Akshay into the theatre. But that was the end of the saga for the bodyguard. Jab Akshay theatre se nikal rahe the, unhe ek fan ka dhakka laga. The fan tried pushing others aside to get close to Akshay and ended up shoving Akshay. Aki lost his temper and shoved the fan aside. He was furious at his bodyguard and left the venue in a huff. Now, we get that it was the bodyguard's job to protect Akshay, but there are some situations where even your best is not enough. In other news, 9XE.com, the show, finds out that Shahid Kapoor is doing his best to make sure his marriage works. Shahid is a rather chilled out guy. I mean, he's the kind of guy you can imagine yourself hanging out with and talking about random stuff. But talk to him about his marriage and he clams up. Shahid married Delhi girl Meera Rajput this July, and whenever anyone's asked him about married life, the guy's gotten pretty defensive. But 9XE.com, the show, got him to finally, and I mean finally, open up and speak about being married. And the first thing he confessed to us is that he was super scared about taking the plunge.
It's totally natural, and I think people should kind of be aware of the fact that you're making a commitment which is a long-term commitment. And it's not easy, you know, signing up for something that you believe and you want should be a part of your life for the rest of your life, because I think as people we change and evolve and we discover new sides to ourselves, you know. But that doesn't mean you can give up on something as important and as fundamental as marriage. So I guess I was scared about getting married because I understood the seriousness of it, you know. So it kind of came from that place.
Shahid caught everyone off guard when he went and got hitched to Meera, who has absolutely no connection to the film industry and is basically a girl next door. So how easy or tough will it be for them to sustain the marriage under the pressure of stardom?
I think eventually it's about how well two people can understand each other and how much they really want to make it work. I really feel like a lot of times people give up on marriage because they just don't try hard enough. Because I think everything is a phase. I mean, that's what I've learned from life. Like, everything's a phase. Everything that's true today will not be true tomorrow. Like, it has to change.
Now that Shahid knows how to tide over the bad times, does he think there's a right age to get married?
I can't comment on that because I've seen some really successful marriages with people who got married really young. I've seen people who got married at a later age somehow not being able to deal with it. I guess the more you get used to being on your own, the more difficult it is to like be with somebody else and share your life with somebody else, share your house, share your, you know, everything, like, you know, your experiences. So when you get used to being alone for a long period of time, I think it makes it more difficult to adjust to a new person.
There you go. Shahid has finally spoken about what it's like being married. You can thank us now. We are accepting thanks in chocolates. But moving on, will director Mohit Suri accept Katrina Kaif as his heroine? So you know that Katrina Kaif and Ranbir Kapoor have been the talk of Tinseltown for a while now, but both are tight-lipped about when they will tie the knot. Lekin agar aap soch rahe hain ki Katrina chup-chap baithkar Ranbir ka intezar kar rahi hai, to you are wrong. Katrina is concentrating on her career and is trying to bag as many projects as possible, and she has her eyes set on a big-ticket film. 9xe.com exclusively has it that Kat's trying to convince director Mohit Suri to cast her as the female lead in the movie version of Half Girlfriend. And how is she doing this? Well, the director's cell phone buzzes quite a few times with messages from Kat. And Katrina's messages tried convincing Mohit that she can do justice to the role of Ria Somani, a hoity-toity Delhi girl who falls in love with Madhav Jha, a boy from Bihar. The movie version of Half Girlfriend is in the news even before the first frame has been shot. There are rumors that Alia Bhatt has been approached, which only got stronger when Alia tweeted a photo of the book. Kriti Sanon's name joined the mix when she appeared and read an excerpt from the book at the book launch with author Chetan Bhagat. Seems Kat doesn't mind stealing the role from these girls, but it's not like she has a dearth of projects. Katrina has Jagga Jasus, Fitur, and Bar Bar Dekho, a Nitya Mehra project that has her sharing screen space with Siddharth Malhotra. Well, there's no stopping this girl, is there? Coming up in an exclusive interview, Aishwarya gets candid about her comeback and being a working mother. Ranveer Shore takes the blame for his separation from Konkana. Welcome back to 9xe.com, the show, your source for everything Bollywood. And now we have an exclusive interview with Aishwarya Rai Bachchan, who makes a comeback with Jazba. Watch her speak about the film, her favorite movies, her experiences as a working mother, and what the future holds for her. And with her is director Sanjay Gupta, who speaks about how he convinced Aishwarya to do the role.
A very enthusiastic, eager artist is who I always am on the start, during the course of, and even at the end of the making of a film. That's my attitude. I mean, every day is what excites us to go to work. And I've always said we are blessed that our passion is our job, our careers, our professional choice. And as long as you're passionate and excited to go and work on set, that attitude remains consistent. Very easy. He's just a wonderful actor to work with. He's everything I believed, I guess. When I said I wanted to work with him, when I saw him in this part, when you see the way the dialogues are written, you see Irfan. You see Irfan rendering these lines in his classical way, which is very, very strong and makes his point, and yet it is with such ease. It has his own charisma, you know, which is very real for us in a commercial film, if that's what you want to say. You know, it's that sense of realism with its own sense of drama is so integral to the way these dialogues will be rendered, to the way Johan, that's the name of his character, is essayed. I kept smiling and saying, I said, Irfan, you're a bad habit man to work with, you know. I mean, really, we were discussing other people who had spoken to us independently before that. And we were glad this is where we have started working together. And I keep saying started because I really hope we work together a lot more ahead. Shravana ji and me, we have worked together in the past. We have interacted a lot. We've done a lot in terms of, worked with her on Mijban and so on and so forth. We know each other over the years. She had met me at the very beginning of my career. In fact, she had met me for a film at her place. And every time I look at her, I keep saying, God, I still remember those. Her eyes are amazing. And at that time also, she had told me, baby, it's being about at the right place at the right time. And she'd given me such a lot of, she was talking to me, but that turned out to be advice at the start of my career. And today here, we were working together on a film I would have always imagined working with her on. It's the kind of subject I would have imagined working with her on. She's just, the name of her character is Garima ji in this film. And it's just perfect for her. So I'm so glad I got to work with her on a film like this. And yes, I have taken her a couple of times, but not onto set. It's just the multitasking mother. But it's not much to make a do about or to necessarily speak about on a public platform. I guess in our vocation, we are lucky being working mothers. We can sometimes take our children to our workplace.
I persuaded her husband. Yes. I went through Abhishek, and then after that, like she said, I mean, once we knew the kind of film we are trying to make, it was, you know, I hamesha ye emphasize karta hu baat pe ke niyat bahut zaruri hoti hai. Pata hai ki niyat saaf hai, acha kaam karna hai, ek achi film banani hai. Har kahani ka एक लीड कैरेक्टर होता है, एक हीरो होता है, ठीक है. इस कहानी का भी हीरो है, फर्क कितना है कि वो हीरोइन है. और इन द सेंस इट्स द द द हीरोइन इज द हीरो ऑफ द फिल्म और व्हाट एवर वे यू वुड लाइक टू पुट इट. द प्रोटैगनिस्ट, माय हीरो इज अ फीमेल इन दिस फिल्म. एंड यू नीड वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग शोल्डर्स टू कैरी इट. दैट वॉज द फर्स्ट क्राइटेरिया. जब कहानी मेरे पास आई भी थी, ओरिजिनल फिल्म भी मैंने देखी थी, आई वॉज वेरी क्लियर. आई सेड ये किसी के साथ में भी नहीं बना सकता. यू नीड समबडी जो किसी हीरो से कम ना हो. सो देन ऑब्वियसली शी इज द ऑब्वियस चॉइस.
वर्किंग विद करण अगेन, मेंट टू ऑल द फिल्म मेकर्स मेंट टू बी, बट एट डिफरेंट पॉइंट्स इन टाइम ऑफ करियर इट जस्ट डिडंट वर्क आउट. And here we are working together, but on a subject like this, which is a love story, but it still is different. So it's nice to be getting to do a part like that in his Ae Dil Hai Mushkil. And then, of course, Sarabjeet with Umang. I mean, you can well gauge the content matter there on a subject as strong as that. So a good variety to work with.
After that, here is a shocking disclosure that the recently separated Ranveer Shore made to the media. 9xc.com had carried the story about Ranveer Shore and Konkana Sen Sharma announcing their separation via Twitter. The split came after much speculation that all was not well between the two. And going further, Ranveer seems to have decided to steel up and face the media about the couple's decision to separate. And what we got was a shocking statement. At a recent media interaction, Ranveer was asked if he still believed in the institution of marriage, and the actor had this to say.
I take it this is about our recent announcement for my separation. So, but I don't blame the institution of marriage for anything. I blame myself for that. I don't think the institution of marriage has anything to do with that.
Ranveer and Konkana began dating in 2007 and were married in a private ceremony in 2010. Good to see that Ranveer is dealing with the split in a mature way, at least in public. Coming up, Salman blames bad times on karma. Ranveer and Arjun to reunite on screen. Welcome back to 9xe.com, the show where Bollywood gossip is served hot off the press. So last episode, we told you the perks of catching Salman Khan in a good mood. That's when he's open and speaks his mind freely. And looks like that streak is continuing, only this time it has a philosophical edge to it. Salman has just launched the trailer of his family drama, Prem Ratan Dhan Payo. And knowing the film's director, Suraj Barjatya, the movie will most likely be all goody-goody and sugary sweet. However, there was nothing sweet going on in Salman's life while he was shooting the film. Salman's hearings in the 2002 hit and run case, as well as the Black Buck case, had come up. But he did not let it affect his work. In fact, he made sure that his work only got better. Listen to Bhai talk about these difficult times.
He's gone through that difficult time. That does not reflect on the film. So whenever I'm going through a difficult time in my life, my work on film is that much better. So please, remember that. And then do not let the difficult time hamper the release of the film. Because we worked a lot on that, difficult time, on that film. I'm still going through it, I'll keep on going through it. That's my share of karma.
Well, there you go. That's Salman's attitude while dealing with the tough times. There was Jay Viru, there was Karan Arjun, and now there's Ranveer Arjun. That's correct. Ranveer Singh and Arjun Kapoor's bromance is now the stuff of legends. Well, almost. Even if the duo gave us a damn squib gunde, the two had crackling chemistry that got them other projects. While their AIB roast appearance was highly controversial, they received praise from their IFA Awards hosting gig. And now 9xe.com has it that Ranveer and Arjun are all set to face the camera together once again. This time for a biscuit brand advertisement. Aur andar ki khabar ye hai ki pehle ad koi aur karne wala tha, lekin fir unhone socha ki Ranveer aur Arjun se acha koi nahi. And why did this happen? Well, the brand managers of the biscuit brand in question thought that Ranveer and Arjun would resonate more with the youth as opposed to the 40 plus actors they were initially trying to approach. Also, Ranveer and Arjun came at a much lower price. Their charge added together was less than the big superstars. Well, less money or not, we are sure this one is going to be a smasher of an ad, and we are definitely looking forward to watching it. And that's all we have for you on this episode, but tune in to 9xe.com, the show, on Wednesday evening. Till then, talk to us on facebook.com/9xe and follow us on Twitter at 9xe the show. Also, download our free 9xe app for Android and iOS, and you can also check out our site, 9xe.com, and our YouTube channel for all the latest happenings in Bollywood. Bye, guys!